I do solemnly swear
that I will support and defend
I will support and defend
the Constitution of the United States
the Constitution of the United States
So I came to the city of Santa Ana at the age of 11. And because I moved so much as a child, went to 9 different elementary schools, when I came actually to Santa Ana, I made a vow and a commitment that I would never leave again. Stability was so important for me. And when I came to this city, it provided that for me. It was my family. And as I look back, probably one of the best decisions was for me to stay here in the city of Santa Ana. My story is unconventional, and so how I began this journey in elected office was one that wasn't easy because of my family background. But as I look at my political background and how I was able to navigate, it was really looking at from an academic sense and really not wanting to be a politician, but be a policymaker so that I can transform a community that in many respects was my family, and I wanted to pay it forward. And so I knew through the power of policy that I would be able to change people's lives.
She's had a challenging life. I would suggest that most people would have said she could have never achieved what she has achieved. She probably had more people tell her that she couldn't do things than people that have told her that she could do.
It is an amazing story I could write a book about, with the beginning in life she has and with the obstacles and challenges she have to be where she is today.
What are some things that Michelle has done for the Santa Ana community that have most impressed you? Is it the homelessness?
It's not one thing, it's how deeply she cares about it, how passionately she cares about it. There is always an issue. There's always going to be something in front of the council, the mayor, but it's the caring, it's the consistency. It's absolutely passionate and deeply felt.
She is always willing to listen to a new idea.
If Michelle sets her mind onto something, you have an option. You either need to get aboard with her or to get out of her way.
She always figured out a way to look into the future and realize that things that work today might not work tomorrow.
The amount of knowledge that she had was astounding to me.
And she always went for taking risks. Calculated risk, but she did. Not only her ability to communicate and collaborate with leaders, but her ability in a very short words to put the issues on the table. Her ability to build relations that didn't exist. Her ability to make people feel very comfortable when she talks to them. That really impressed me about her.
Like Michelle, who could take all of those different constituencies and thoughts and try to put that together and make the best decision. Then you've got courage, compassion, wisdom. You I think, have a very dedicated public servant.
I've done a lot on this city council in my 12 years as it pertains to policy. I think one of the first things that I was able to do that was very transformational for me, making sure that this city built affordable housing for those who were most vulnerable, who were displaced. Many years ago within the Santa Ana Boulevard corridor, and now we have affordable housing down that corridor. The second thing that I can tell you that I'm very proud of is that the city had a 30-year-old outdated general plan and a 60-year-old outdated zoning code. And essentially, it took me 10 years to get the city moving in direction to finally update those plans, and that I was able to bring millions of dollars to make sure that that plan was going to come to fruition. And I would say the final thing is active transportation. This city had major fatalities of people either on their bicycles or walking right after the top three cities in the state of California were Los Angeles, San Francisco, and then came Santa Ana. And so I really dedicated my life to putting safety first and putting the residents first and bringing the infrastructure that was necessary to help mitigate some of those safety concerns while our residents were walking or biking.
It's been a total of 12 years that I've known Michelle. I've seen the growth in Michelle from the young girl that I met 12 years ago into a mature, pragmatic person. a person that will weigh both sides. I'm just so honored to have been around and to watch her grow. And I'll tell anybody that's out there listening to this, Michelle's not done yet. She's still a very young lady. She still has goals.
She's still young. Whole future is ahead of her, but I expect her to go somewhere in life. Not because some people are going to mentor her or some people are going to help her, but because she never forgets where she came from. She is focused, and she pretty much knows every aspect of what it takes to be a great leader.
I told everyone that I would be the best policymaker that this city would ever have. And I think as I leave 12 years later, in 2018, that I have become one of the best policymakers in the city of Santa Ana's history, and I believe I will be for a very long time the elected official that really put people first and led my policy with making sure that the people came first.